Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. We've got something quite different for you today. So as you may know, the electric vehicle market is something that's growing very fast in the UK. Just recently we had a pledge by the government to ban the sale of all new petrol and diesel cars by 2035, which means that electric cars, as far as we can see, are going to be the future. Today I've got the brand new Tesla Model 3 Standard Range Plus. And I was actually present for the delivery of this car a few months back, which was an interesting process, and I will talk about that a bit later. So first of all, looking at the car, one of the things that's talked about quite a lot about the Tesla Model 3 is its design. Many people have said it's quite a boring design, it's a bit plain. I honestly don't think it is. I think this thing's got some really nice design features that many cars don't have. So looking at the front end of the car, it's quite a nice presence, to be honest. There's some nice open vents on the car. There's not fake vents, which is interesting because a lot of the new German cars obviously have fake vents to try and enhance their front ends, rear ends and whatever to make the car look better. On the Tesla Model 3, there are some nice vents and some nice just lines that are put in just to sort of enhance the design. And obviously being an electric car, you don't need a radiator grille, so we've got a completely solid front with no openings really going into the car, just some small vents either side to guide air sort of in and around the wheels. So today I've got the Tesla Model 3 Standard Range Plus, which is the base model here in the UK, and that comes with a WLTP range of 254 miles. It's not easy to find the actual horsepower figures, obviously with it being electric, but I think it's roughly 280 horsepower with around 330 foot-pounds of torque. Obviously being electric, that power and torque is instant, so this thing feels pretty damn quick compared to the equivalent petrol car. But yeah, I mean, base model, this starts at about £40,000 after the £3,500 government grant here in the UK. So, you know, I mean, the thing with the Tesla Model 3 is it's kind of opened up the electric vehicle market to more of the masses. It's within range of a lot more people than, say, the Model S and the Model X that Tesla had obviously brought out in recent years. On the finance rates, it's relatively quite affordable. So I think, yeah, the Tesla Model 3 is probably going to be, well, we know it is a car that's been sold in large volumes already. It's been out since about August of 2019, and there's already quite a few of these things on the road, so they're obviously very popular. Another cool thing about the Tesla Model 3 is its charge rates. So at supercharging points, you can actually do an 80% charge in about 30 minutes, which is really impressive. So even with that 254 mile range, doing long journeys is pretty easy, because if you need a stop for charge, quick stop at a supercharger point, of which there are quite a few in the UK now, not loads, but it's a growing network. So yeah, I mean, over time we're just going to see more and more of these, and yeah, 30 minutes you can do an 80% charge, which is probably going to be around about 180 to 200 miles range, depending on your driving style. So for those of you that are familiar with the Tesla brand, you may have heard there's often been a few questions about build quality and just overall sort of quality of the car when it's handed over to customers. As I mentioned at the start, I was actually present for the delivery of this vehicle, and it was quite disappointing actually that the number of cars that had passed the pre-delivery inspection but still had multiple marks on the paint, the interiors weren't as clean as you'd like. I mean, in fairness to them, they did have a detailing team there who were sorting out the issues and just getting the cars ready, but in all honesty, if you went to any other manufacturer, I'm sure that those things would all be sorted before you pick up the car. And considering the sums of money involved, it would be nice if they'd done that off their own accord. I have to say that the actual paint quality is really quite good, and once it had been cleaned up, it's spotless, to be honest. It's a really good finish. And same with the panel gaps. Another thing that's been an issue before on the Tesla models is just the huge panel gaps that can exist. However, on this car, I can say from having a look around that there's actually no ridiculous panel gaps. Everything fits perfectly. The build quality just throughout the whole car is actually really impressive. There's no squeaks or rattles. Everything just seems like it's built to a really high standard, which is great. So moving on to the inside of the Model 3, I have to say it's a really nice place to be. These seats are great. Nice soft leather. I've been in this car in a few longer distances and it is really comfortable, I can say that much. The driving position is also really good. You can get the seat nice and low. Obviously one of the main features is this big screen in the middle. I have to say it's definitely something that takes a bit of getting used to, but to be honest, it means you can focus a lot more on actually driving the car, because you've not got anything in front of you to distract you. And with all the information that you need, like the speed and everything, on the right hand side of that screen, it does make it really easy to use, which is great. Obviously it's quite a minimalistic place to be. There's not too much going on in here. The design is very sort of, as I say, minimalistic, but I quite like that. It's something different. A lot of car interiors these days are quite cluttered with buttons and just lots of screens and things going on, but it's just nice to have that one screen, steering wheel, minimal buttons, and just everything you need really. As I mentioned before, the build quality, it's really quite good. There's no squeaks or rattles in here. Everything feels well put together. Nothing is sort of misaligned or anything like that. So yeah, really nice place to be. Can't fault the interior at all. The Tesla Model 3 has really good storage space actually. Opening the boot, you can see it goes really long way back. We've also got underfloor storage as well, which is really nice. And yeah, I mean, it's just a massive boot. Obviously, you've got much less drivetrain components, so the boot itself can be a lot bigger. So obviously, having no engine in the Tesla Model 3, there's quite a bit of space in the front, and it makes enough room to have a frunk or front boot. So that's just even more usable storage. It is quite big, actually. You could probably get a decent sized suitcase in there, and it's all just usable space. So yeah, Tesla Model 3 has definitely got plenty of room for luggage. So I honestly think the Tesla Model 3 is quite a cool thing. Obviously, I'm a massive petrol head myself, and you'll be able to tell that from the other videos on the channel. But I think it's fair to accept that petrol and diesel cars just aren't going to be around for much longer. So we've got to embrace this new technology. And the Tesla Model 3 is a really cool bit of kit. It's very technologically advanced. And to be honest, as we've seen with the other performance models, with the P100D, and obviously there's the Tesla Model 3 performance, they can also be fun. And I honestly think Teslas have made electric cars cool, because before this we just had a lot of boring stuff with weird designs, and the Tesla Model 3, it's a really good looking car in my opinion. So yeah, I'm really quite a big fan of the Tesla Model 3, and I'll hopefully bring you some more content on this thing in the future if you're interested. So stay tuned, we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.